Well, I just had a very interesting experience with one Zhivago Grigio, a very handsome man from Brazil. It's not my preference, a handsome man. It's just a description. I prefer a handsome woman. But when you have, like, a Ryan Gosling next to you, and he doesn't speak a lick of English or... Well, the thing is, I didn't know Spanish was different than Portuguese. I'm not interested in Zhivago Grigio being here. He just noticed the waft of nice air coming from my apartment. His granny had been taking him all over town to get dope, and he can't speak a lick of English. So he's been going into card shops here around Ann Arbor and stuff. So then he implored me for my services. Implored? He didn't speak English, but he's very smiley and very handsome. I'm not attracted to him. He's just a handsome man. It's in, like one time I was walking outside the Beauty and the Beast theaters, and in New York City, not just because I'm trolling the theater. I'm walking past the backstage of the Beauty and the Beast, and the door flies open, and Gaston steps on my toe. And it hurt like hell. He crushed my foot. But I was like, wow, that is a handsome man. But I'm not lusting for him. I lust over a girl in a garbage can over of a handsome man. I'm just... The point is, I took in this very handsome man, Zhivago Grigio. I was teaching him the wrong language. Like, he said he wanted to learn English, but I was teaching him wrong. And so, like, he was asking me what something was called. He was holding it up, and it had a picture of a bird on it. And I thought he meant the bird, but he meant, like, what is this frame? What do you do with this frame? Like, what's it called? And so I'm saying that's a bird. That's a bird off there. That's a bird off there. I'm like, is that a, you want to know what the frame is or the bird off there? I'm trying to, it was like talking to a deaf person, to be honest. And he just starts laughing. He's like, bird off? I'm like, yeah, bird off. He's like, ha, 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 bird off, bird off. So he's repeating that as in like, that's what he thinks the picture frame is. That's like a 3D frame. He thinks it's called a bird off now. He had this app on his phone that you could type in anything and it would translate it immediately from Portuguese to English and vice versa. So that was funny. Like, he typed it. I'm like, hey, yeah, what's up, man? And I saw him in the hallway, and he, like, typed to me, and then you could just hear it blazing through the hallway. May you please find a place for me to buy weed, or do you have weed? I'm like, God almighty, turn it down, first of all. Second off, yeah, you have to have a card here. He's asking me, do you have to have a weed card to buy weed here in this weed state? Like, everything you would translate. So I would have to say it into the phone, and then it would translate it back to Portuguese. And think about me even trying to say something into a phone. It's like about a bunch of bullshit at once. I'm trying to get a thousand thoughts off to him, so I leave a paragraph. And then it just spits it all out in Portuguese. And I see him laughing, so I guess I'm funny in Portugal. But anyway, I kicked him the fuck out of here and made room for my... Well, no, I didn't. He's a nice guy. He's allowed back anytime. But I did have to make room for some boxes. Not that he was really taking up that much space. I mean, he's just a man. A very handsome man. I don't care how heterosexual you are, if your penis is straight as an arrow, you still can't, like, walk up to the... You can't, like, be approached by four, like, Gucci models and not find, like, one of them to be handsome. Not attractive, but you have to say at least, oh, they're not all ugly. Oh, that's a handsome guy. What am I doing to myself? God. Plead the Fifth should be tattooed right on my scrotum and forehead, so I'll never forget. I see my scrotum more than my forehead is why I say that, and because it'd be a much more intense memory. How, you never see your own forehead. The only time I've ever seen your forehead is in a mirror, huh? I've never seen my own face. Ugh, that thought makes me angry. Everyone's seen my face but me that I've met. The pussycat's looking at me right now. He's seen my face. That was a weird 40 minutes, not just because we were doing the deed, but again, God, I fucking Tobias Bluth here. No, I'm not sexual innuendoing this. So then it became especially entertaining to try to use even small words around him that he didn't understand. And I'm just like totally forgetting over and over and over that he doesn't speak one word of English outside of thank you. And so he's just like, oh, thank you, thank you. I'm like, de nada, de nada. And then I just go back into my tirades of... whatever I was talking to him about. Brazil. Actually, the chicas in Brazil. I've heard nothing about Brazil but the beautiful women, and I asked him that, and he seemed to be enthused. And he just kept asking, what is it, a bird off? And he just kept repeating it, bird off, this frame is called a bird off, bird off, ha ha ha, bird off, ha ha ha, bird off. Like, yep. And then I realized, like, it's harder to tell him he's wrong than to read. I mean, if you don't speak a lick of English, I mean, I even speak, like, I spoke more Spanish than he did English. That's insane. And I know, like, 15 words, and they're, like, numbers 1 through 15. Quince, catorce, quince. Ugh. How did languages even develop? How were you all using a different language? With all the, you know, we all have the same Nintendo games, the same PlayStation game here as in Japan, but we can't seem to lock down a language. You know, you go somewhere else, all their advertising is useless. Advertising is completely useless to all the foreigners. I mean, maybe they can recognize, like, you know, a logo of some sort. The Starbucks logo. If I had to be trapped in solitary confinement, like in jail forever, with one coffee cup, it would be the Starbucks logo, because there's still something titillating about the girl holding her legs up. And the picture, I never even knew that till middle school. Someone said, you know, that's the girl spreading her legs and holding them up, the mermaid or whatever. I never noticed that. So sometimes I'll see a Starbucks cup, and I'm thinking of this girl, spread eagle, holding her legs up. And I'm like, that's not too bad. I'd rather be stuck down there than with a Beaner's cup or a Dunkin'. All right, you're going to solitary confinement with a D. Steve? You're a goddamn shit-eating son of a bitch. It's time to shut up.